All right. Now, Peter, if once you're plugged in and ready to unleash the beast, if you could tell us a little bit about yourself, where you come from, what you do, how you like to roll, as it were. Lots of nice looking women walking down the avenue. Not that I'm, you know, trolling around. Anyways. Yes, sir. Tell us a little bit about where you're from.
Tulsa, Oklahoma. I saw Jimi Hendrix when I was 5 years old on my brother's shoulders. I'm not a comedian, but I love this anthem. It has a lot of different styles. And I'm going to try to cram as many as I can in 5 minutes or whatever we got.
Let me ask you a question. Being from Tulsa, do you go out and see Tommy Crooks at all play?
Yeah, I played with him. I've known him.
Excellent.
Tommy Crooks, for you, if you've ever been to Tulsa, Oklahoma, and you go, you got to go see Tommy Crooks play. And also Peter Banfield as well. I guess he's going to unleash the beast like a warrior of the night. So, how did you hear about this contest?
I was sitting in my interview at the last minute. I didn't know I was even in it. And they called me and said, well, have you won? And I thought it was a joke. And they go, no, you're flying to Chicago. I'm like, that's great.
Excellent.
So, really cool. And I'm going to try to, I didn't get to use the card or anything, but I'm going to try to cram in a bunch of styles in 5 minutes.
Cool.
As much as I can. So.
Sounds good. Let's hear it for Peter.
Woo! Thank you.
up there for the critique.
Whoa!
Hey, stay for the critique.
Fine chandelier. Come on, Peter, let's hear it for him! A fabulous earring, ladies and gentlemen. No, that's right, it was my massive cranium that hit it. Let's hear it for Peter and his incendiary musical stylings. At one point, he sensed that he had a plaque issue and addressed it accordingly. Using the strings of the guitar to dislodge some food items. I think that shows massive creativity as well. Also used the phrase sampler, used different sounds. That was a G-Deck freakout! Nicely played. Let's hear what our judges have to say for themselves.
Greg, I think you summed it up, the freakout aspect. I mean, did the whole place levitate for a moment? Did everyone feel the shredness of this gentleman?
Yeah!
I mean, really, it was entertaining, all the things we needed, you messed with the deck. The idea that these things are made for musicians to take them and take them to a place that the people who made it didn't even know they could go to. That whole looping at the end, that cacophony of just sounds and shreds and loops and riffs, I soiled myself. But anyways, that's a good thing. Well done and well played. It was entertaining. You obviously have worked well on your instrument, and that shows. And I think everyone enjoyed, loves seeing a player play the guitar like you do. So chops off to there.
Yeah!
That was very, very kick-ass.
Wait, there's two more.
Very kick-ass. Very good use of the G-Deck and everything, you know, loops and all that kind of stuff. It was really, really cool. I really, really enjoyed it. Sorry. Destruction here at the Hard Rock!
Oh, I forgot, I'm not Steven Tyler, I'm sorry. Peter, it was really inspiring. As the Fender amp got one critique, every amp has a sweet spot. It sounded like the amp was on 10 and it was just like...
I didn't mean to do that.
Exploding. Well, you gotta react in real time on the gig. But that's me, the Fender amp guy.
Silent.
On it. Yes. Sold. On the plus side, you went from rockabilly to two-handed tapping to Hendrix. You used the phrase sampler. You used your freaking teeth, for crying out loud. So I give a really good score. Well done.
Thank you.
Yeah.